from how or what we think Goa is, there is some part of it which can only be felt when you plan to explore the heart of Goa, South Goa. So let's dive into this 3-day journey and I'll explain what are the things you should do and what not. Good morning from Agonda Beach. Today we are planning to take a dip in the ocean. These waves are too high, yaar. I don't know. I'm a little scared of water, so spare me for that. But let's do this! So today we are going to Kola Beach and let's see how the roads are.
The road to Kola Beach is very bad. Very bad. If you're coming via a sedan or something,
there are various spots where you can park your car and walk to the beach. Scooties are still fine. But let's ask the person who is driving the car.
Let's ask the car person.
Behind me it's the Kola Beach and as you can see the whole portion has become red now. Just so beautiful. Actually I'm just loving the colors and variety. And if you wonder where the kayaking is happening, it's just behind me here in this lagoon. So this is the Blue Lagoon which is just near the Kola Beach. You can come here, it's very reasonable. 100 rupees per person for half an hour. If you want to extend, you can do that.
Ta-da! So this is a very small blue lagoon where you can do this kayaking thing. And they have put a barrier also, so you are not supposed to go ahead of it. But this is very beautiful, yaar. You know, the breeze is so cooler than the beach. I've just learned this technique, but I am horribly bad in it. Learning my best, but let's see.
So this is the kayaking experience which you all should definitely have. At least if you are having some time crunch, you can have it for half an hour. It's up to you, but don't forget to visit it.
We explored two cafes after kayaking. One was near to Kola Beach and we had a yummy pasta. And the second was on our way to Cabo de Rama Fort. So we went to Cape Goa and man, what a place. Let's go. And not just about pictures, but what a view from that place. I was just in awe after seeing Cape Goa. And after visiting Cape Goa, we have come to Cabo de Rama Fort to explore this place. I have heard that sunsets from this place are mind-blowing. So let's figure it out. Can you see the view from here? It's just gorgeous. The moment you enter here, there's a church over here. And then if you go, there are like two directions. But all of them will go towards the end of that fort where you can witness a very gorgeous and breathtaking sunset. Actually, we were finding the other edge of this place and it's been 10 minutes that we are still roaming here and there. And I guess we have finally found that wall of the fort which we were looking for. And yes, if you are visiting Goa, don't miss this fort, guys. It's been a popular place. It doesn't need an introduction, but still, if you're not aware, don't forget this. A perfect sunset to end our day one in Goa. Good morning everyone, and today we are planning to go to Butterfly Beach and spot some dolphins. And the best time to witness it during the sunrise, which is around 6:30 to 7:30 or maybe till 8. The minimum charges will be around 1000 rupees per head. This is the turtle rock, basically a formation of a rock in the shape of turtle. Butterfly Beach. Come by boat, but boat will not be landing on that beach shore. So that's all I have. And we have reached Honeymoon Beach. यू नो ऐसा फील आ रहा है एकदम कि 2000 रुपए लिए फॉर 1.5 आवर एंड वी हैव रुइंड इट फॉर 1 बीच दिस बीच व्हिच इज एक्चुअली नॉट अ बीच इट्स जस्ट फुल ऑफ रॉक्स एंड आई डोंट नो देयर इज सम नेक्स्ट लेवल स्टफ गोइंग ऑन सो डोंट गो फॉर दिस ट्रैप डोंट गो फॉर दिस ट्रिप यू जस्ट गो टू बटरफ्लाई ट्रैक डाउन फॉर 1 आवर और मे बी दैट्स व्हाट दे से एंड Dolphin, I'm not sure whether you will spot it or not. We have seen dolphin. So this was water. This was dolphin. We have seen dolphin. So choose wisely while choosing these kind of plans which will trap you when you're at a gondola. That's the harsh truth, man. I was just missing this boat ride, so it feels like, okay, it was worth it. If you're really looking for a nice boat ride, maybe, this is the one. After doing kayaking in the Blue Lagoon, I always wanted to do it in the ocean. So we decided and headed towards Palolem Beach for this kayaking experience during the sunset.
There's just one simple rule for kayaking. If you want to go left, pedal right. If you want to go right, pedal left. And that's how it works. It's so simple as that. After doing it in Blue Lagoon, I feel that was nothing. This is great.
This is day 3 in Goa and today we're gonna explore Netravalli Wildlife Sanctuary. I've heard a lot about this place and if you're staying in Agonda, it's just 40 kilometers away from this place. So we are starting our trip at 12 o'clock right now. I'll tell you how the route is, what are the charges and is it worth to visit this wildlife sanctuary. So basically per person it's 100 rupees, for your car it's 100 rupees fee and for camera it's 50 rupees. So basically this is the Tanishq Spice Farm. It's a package of 2000 where you can have a safari, jungle safari, which will be towards the waterfall, including the spice farm tour and stay, including veg, lunch, breakfast and dinner, which is not a bad deal. But yeah, if you're coming here just for the tour, maybe it's 600 rupees including the lunch. So it depends on you. Anyways, we just wanted to see how it is and we are heading towards the waterfall. And let me show you what is the way. It's another 6 kilometer from here. So let's go. So you can park your cars here and from here it's a 1 kilometer trek. So let's go and see how difficult it is. Currently we are in Chappal, so we are a little worried. Now I can actually hear the sound of water. So I feel that we are pretty close to the waterfall. And I will say it's a very decent waterfall you should definitely visit. If you want some dip there. So there's a small pool as well. You can easily take a dip here and change your clothes. Also have one more waterfall and strawberry land visit. So there are 3 to 4 places which you can visit here. Some must visit if you are near South Goa. After Netravalli, we were damn hungry and we headed directly towards my favorite cafe in Goa, Zest. A highly recommended, amazing cafe which won't disappoint you at any point of time. It got lots of vegetarian and vegan options. I was damn impressed by this cafe. And it was my daily routine to visit Zest at least for one meal a day. And after having our food, we directly headed towards Palolem again for a beautiful sunset. And guess what? We again took a dip in the ocean. That's how we ended our 3 days in South Goa. And Man, I would say that's the best decision I have taken, to choose South over North Goa. I hope you like this video, so don't forget to like, share, subscribe and hit the bell icon for notifications. And take care guys. ये देखिए आप, हमारी दुल्हन बन जाती है ये धूप आते ही, अलग ही गमछा लेके. And we have reached honeymoon beach.
And they have put a barrier also, so you are not supposed to go ahead of it. अरे जा सकते हैं वो लोग तो चले गए.
How excited Anand is? Let's figure it out.
He's
thinking about the sarcasm. He's thinking about the dialogue. Because he believes in giving it a dialogue and just making it da 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 da. They also have one spot which is a house which is. How old was the house?